Welcome to ECCSC Live. I'm your host, Tyrone Muhammad. Thank you for tuning in once again. And to my right, maybe your left, but to my right, the mighty Mark Carter. How you doing, Mark?
Good evening.
Welcome back. We got a few subjects and topics we would like to talk about and speak on, similar to what we spoke on before, but we need to expand on the ideals and as well as a process. But first of all, I would like to thank the brothers and sisters and the families who have supported and looked out for me as it relates to my short jail stint as a result of us standing on this nail salon. You got a lot of emotions and it's heated. And it's almost like, you know, the more, let me show y'all something real quick before I get started. Mark be talking about my little puppy son. Hey, Mark, this is not a cat. This is my buddy.
Oh, I get it mixed up with a cat sometimes.
No, man. This is my little buddy. Okay. This is my puppy son, Cream.
All right.
Hey, buddy. Hey, stay. Sit your butt. So anyway, they missed you, man. Say, what's up, Cream? Say, wave to the people. So anyway, the nail salon, everything is going well. For that, Mark, the owners of the place said they're going to kill at least for that nail salon.
The mall. The mall, right.
They're going to kill at least. And even after talking to the Vietnamese guy, Tony, who owned the salon, who actually run it, he realized he's defeated. He's realized that it's over. And he just buying time, I guess, until they come and shut them down all the way. But that's a victory for us. Without Although that. We hope that those sisters and those brothers that's out there continue in the line that they are, because we're winning regardless. If he didn't say that, if he didn't agree that he was done, he throwing in the towel, we were still going to make sure he throw in the towel. With all due respect to everybody out there, and I give my props to those brothers that's out there still, like the Jamal, and as well as Martin, the crime chaser, regardless to the heated... Hold on, buddy. You stay still. I'm going to put you down. Okay, go. Regardless to how we disagree in approach and method, my approach is not their approach, so we're going to bump heads when it comes to trying to get freedom for us. You got anything to say about that?
Well, today probably was the... Well, not probably. Today was the first time I actually came out, and the reason why I hadn't really come out is because, you know, some of the things that I've seen happen, I can take a different approach sometimes, and so sometimes it's best for me to just stay back. But, coming out there and seeing those sisters out there that were out there with you all today, ones I've been seeing through social media and everything, man, you know, when we bring men and women together in our community, then the fight is really strong.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know prior to the 1970s, the black family was fighting the civil rights movement and fighting the black power movement and all that. And it was J. Edgar Hoover's agenda to make sure he broke that up. J. Edgar Hoover did not want the black family, the black man and woman, to stand side by side and fight. So then they started implementing that whole feminist movement to break down and split and divide the black family agenda. And they start pushing basically the white woman's agenda. The feminist agenda never belonged to black women.
Yes.
And so we must, bring this thing back together and say, hey, to our black women, that look, we're going to start fighting this fight together. Now, there's going to be some times that as men, we got to get out here and put some fights up that we don't want our women out here taking dangerous position on. So it's not that we're leaving them out. It's not that we want to leave them out. But sometimes, you know, situations can be dangerous to the point to where we just ask that they just, you know, stay back a little bit. But that's not, they're not out of the fight. But, you know, that brute force, sometimes we need to take the lead on it, you know. And we would just ask with all due respect. Hey,
you know, and plus it's going to always be heat. It's going to be jealous and envy. It's going to be all type of aspects of stuff when we deal with this. Yeah. First of all, I don't have time for no conversation and talking. Right. I'm about action and getting it done. If you want to holler and scream and do all the things you want to do, do that. But don't criticize and don't judge my method in the way that I get down as it relates to really being out here with our sisters.
See, the name of the game is lead, follow, get the hell out the way.
Get out the way. You know? And too many times, man, we are so distracted because of money.
Mm-hmm,
money
mm-hmm.
transform and make people do things, man, that they wouldn't normally do,
mm-hmm.
Or the lack thereof
mm-hmm,
of money.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, so when you one person is having success, it often tends to make other people envious.
Let me say this to you, bro. You know, after being out here for the last 20 years, I applaud what you did.
Yeah.
Support you 110%. Wouldn't have it done any other way. And so you don't have time to worry about those other things that you know. I don't even know how to say it because I don't know how to be a hater.
Right.
I don't know. I just don't know how to be a hater. You know what I'm saying? And so I can't do
but
it.
But haters don't exist.
Get around. Look, if I ain't going to support you, I'm definitely not going to come out and go against you.
No question. So with that being said, this is the next move. And the next stage is job, contracts, and opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
So that whole place and us bringing a force upon the ownership,
yes, sir,
of that mall as well as Colored Nails.
Mm-hmm.
It's time for us then to now transition. What do that look like for our sisters who are in that business,
mm-hmm.
in that land? And we have a whole list of women that have that do nails.
That's right.
Now we need to create either from that location or another one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we give them opportunity to build on that and expand on their craft as well as make a living doing what they love to do.
and to add to what you're saying, see, it's time that we really start crafting and implementing the Black Family Agenda.
Yeah.
And see, in that Black Family Agenda, we own our own communities.
No,
that means the businesses,
it.
That means our homes, the industry, the healthcare, the education. We have to come in, go in strongly and say, in this area right here, wherever we are as Black people,
you gotta check in with us. Check in.
Because let me tell you, and the reason why we got to have a Black Family Agenda where we own the businesses is because with that situation that happened, that made you go to the extreme to demand and command respect.
But you know, I've done it before at that same location. Continues. You can go on my site. You can go on my Facebook page. You can go wherever you want to go. Mm-hmm. We came in there and I had a discussion with the owner, and he said he was going to create community benefits.
But let's see.
And that package did not happen.
Right. And that's what I'm saying. When we have our own Black Family Agenda, then we wouldn't have to deal with situations like that, period, because we own it.
Of course.
See, we're the only people that don't believe in what I call the cultural cultural based community control development, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cultural based community control development is basically, I'm gonna break it down to what it is. Chinatown,
yes.
Greek town,
yeah.
Little Italy,
right.
Ukrainian village.
Yes.
See, when you have cultural based community control development, you don't have to worry about an agent.
No, there's no question that they own the businesses and that community.
Without a doubt. And that's why we have to change the playbook that we've been running plays from for the last 50, 60 years. Thank you, Grandmom and Granddaddy. Thank you, Mom and Daddy. But what didn't work, we throwing it away and starting something new. What worked, we're going to incorporate it into the overall new agenda. Look, let me say something to you. And the reason why we got to have a Black Family Agenda, why we must own our businesses, why we must control our education. In the city of Chicago, last school year, 16,450 of our children went to school from homeless shelters, abandoned cars, out of abandoned cars, or motels. It's something wrong with that picture.
Hmm.
We got that is a state of emergency. Nothing is more important right now at this point than to make sure that we house these women and children.
So on that point, you know my favorite line, holding the PPs accountable. If you don't know who the PPs are, the pastors and the politicians.
Mm-hmm.
These are the ones.
Or pushing them to the side.
Push to the side.
Right.
You done knew how to do, or you done what you was able to do, or you clearly just sold out.
Mm-hmm.
So then you gonna move out the way and let us start to develop a new agenda.
Right.
Yeah. That's it. Because at the end of the day, if you saying those young men,
mm-hmm.
with all the control that we have, understand this, people, and I'm gonna let Mark have it. Understand this. In this city, we have Black aldermen
mm-hmm.
that control our communities. In this city, we have a number of black pastors with mega churches in our communities.
And these homeless children parents go to their church.
Go to their church. In this city, we have women who own or run the city. Can I name them? Lori Lightfoot, now, although she's new.
Tony Pregwicker.
Tony Pregwicker. Dorothy Brown. The water reclamation girl, Carrie Steele.
Carrie Steele.
We got the state's attorney, Kim Fox. Who we got? The Chicago Public School, Janice Jackson.
But even before
and then we have a black police chief.
Let me tell you, even before that, when a lot of the things that Daley was doing to black people was going on, and then this is no attack. This is just an attack on our sisters.
Right.
But we just want you to be clear what we've been dealing with. Because, see, women and children have been harmed by these deals and these political positions that our people have been holding.
Mm-hmm.
But when Daley was in office, for the most part, the majority of the black elected officials in the city council were female.
Right.
The majority of them.
Right.
He was there,
right.
there for
no
so from 1989 till he retired.
No question. Absolutely.
The majority of
look
them
it up.
Were black females. And so we're saying to our sisters, hey, look, these... few black males, as well as the majority of the females that were there, they were working with Daley against the interests of black men, women, and children who weren't in the city council, who were the citizens in our community. And so, with this black family agenda, that don't happen no more. With this black family agenda, no Asian will never feel that he or she is that comfortable enough to put their hands and their feet on a black woman.
Hmm.
Their hands and their feet
right.
on a black woman. Because we talking about this shop over here. There was the other shop where they showed the video. They put their hands and feet on this sister. You know? And so, to keep you from having to catch a case and then fight this stuff back and forth. Look, we going to do something bigger than just going, just do the protest. That, yeah, that needed to happen because they did what they did. But we need to right. take over our community. Because because we don't, whatever disrespect that they've learned from whoever told them when it comes to us, man, it's going to make them feel like they can do it again.
Yeah.
And somebody going to really get hurt in this thing. You know, I'm telling you, I stayed back, man. I'm glad you went out there and just knocked the windows out. Because I want to knock their windows out.
Yeah. So listen, man, it's just amazing to me. I love it. I love it. It's like, Mark, when you look at everything that we're dealing with and working with this whole system, please stand by, people. We'll be right with you. But we just continue to listen. But all that we've been through and fighting for our sisters in these communities, see, this is what I love,
for
man.
Our people, you know what I'm saying? Just,
that's community in general. So that's include, hopefully, although people don't see those as communities. That I'm talking about. They say, man, I'm just here. So look, where you at? Come on, buddy. Come on up.
And see, we must always make sure that our women are the most protected.
Yeah.
Our women and children are the most protected. But we're here to fight for the best interests of us as a people, as an entire community. And all that has not been community, it's time we make it community.
Yeah.
How do we do that? Across this city, there's literally thousands of vacant and abandoned properties, vacant abandoned lots, vacant abandoned storefronts, vacant abandoned factories. It is time that we take control of our community, and with this black family agenda, we can create our own jobs, contracts, housing, home ownership, investment opportunity, tools to stop violence. All this is wrapped in this real estate that sits in our community. We have the most valuable land that we sit on.
Right.
And this so-called leadership that we have is study telling us to hold up and wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Well, we've been holding
hold
up and wait a
don't
minute.
Don't throw that brick. Just keep on marching and protest.
Look, we don't want to hear nothing that they got to say at this point. If you've been in position for the last 40 years, you've been guiding us in the wilderness. And it's time for us to sit your ass down. Get out of the way. We don't care if you're some kin to us. We don't care if you old. You went old. You didn't start out old.
Right. So I want to say this to you, and being that this is ECCSC on CAN TV, X-Cons for Community and Social Change, for those who just tuning in, maybe we can get that screen now, show that. But
you might need to go over a little bit so they can see it. Okay, there you go.
They know.
Oh, that's right. You got your shirt on.
Ain't no question. But anyway, but what I'm saying is I don't think because of the live that she has, they can see the screen because that's green screen back there. So
okay,
the ECCSC shows
up. T-shirt on, though.
Yeah, they all right. But look, the development in our community.
Mm-hmm.
What it's going to take, where are we getting the funding from, and how do we bring to bear this and make it in the, and as far as in the, making it attention mm-hmm. to those elected officials, because we're not bagging for nothing. Make it clear.
Mm-hmm.
We want our tax dollars.
There you go.
To serve us. Tell us how do we demand, command our tax dollars, as well as with these businesses and our new, because in my opinion, we should shut them all down if they don't look like us.
So
talk about that.
So let me look into this lab and say to the people, because I want you all to understand, no money comes from the federal government to say this is white folks' money.
That's right.
Stop letting these people tell you this is white folks' money. No, this is the taxpayers' money. And since I'm a taxpayer, just like white folks' taxpayers, the same thing that they get, we want it too. Look, the city's budget is $10.6 billion. The Wilder Reclamation budget is $1.7 billion. The Cook County budget is $4 billion. CTA's budget after Rom left was $4 billion. CPS budget is $6.5 billion. Those are the resources.
That's right.
All the goods and services that these agencies vend or buy from outside vendors, we should be those businesses. Stop letting these politicians lie to you and tell you that there's no money. If there's money for your ass, it's money for me too. Now I can see if there's no money for you, then you can justify it by saying that there's no money for me. But no more will we listen to anybody that leads us in the wilderness. We don't care who you are, the preacher, the politician, you know what I mean? Yes. The family members that work in government, we're not standing down and be quiet for nobody. Nobody. We mean nobody. And we have no fear of any of these people who, whatever y'all may think they are, whoever y'all think they are. We've been through the storm already, okay. So there's no fear. So we have to go at all these budgets. And we talk about reparations. Every damn year, reparations come to this city. Every year, right. The state's budget is $100 billion.
So when, why do you, if the money never seemed to trickle down to the community that needed most, why do we keep going through this punk census process?
Because we are being tricked by these politicians who so-called look like us. And for the most part, when we were younger, we couldn't fight it. We didn't understand it. But now, after 40 years in the wilderness, we the Joshua generation. So Moses, go have a seat. Go in the bushes somewhere, you know what I'm saying?
For 40 years.
Following our parents' generation. Our parents and grandparents led us in the wilderness. And for the most part, it was mostly our parents' generation because their parents didn't allow the community to look like this.
Mm-hmm.
There's a difference between our parents' generation and our grandparents' generation. And I'm going to give you the age group so you'll understand because a lot of times people don't understand when I say that. Most of the baby boomer generation, let's talk in generations. The civil rights generation, for the most part, is in their mid and late 70s and older.
Yeah.
That's the civil rights generation. The baby boomer generation would be, for the most part, late 50s on up into early 70s, 71. Mm-hmm. Now, you got baby boomers that were also born in 1964, but I'm talking about the older ones. The older baby boomers, the ones who've been at the helm all our lives. And then you have the X generation, which is our generation.
Yes.
So the civil rights generation, which is our grandparents, which is our children's great-grandparents, they took care of the black community.
Mm-hmm.
We own businesses. We had block parties.
You mean generation X as an ex-con?
Well, whatever you want. X'd out.
X'd out.
X'd out. You know,
X'd all over.
X'd everything. They just made us X'd everything.
Our generation was good. X'd out.
Just X'd everything. And then the generation that come after us, children, are millennials.
Yeah.
And so what we have to do is go back to what grandma and granddaddy taught us. See, grandma and granddaddy taught us unity and love and get it done as a community. It was when our parents then took the helm that had been raised through the public school system that told them that it's all about me. I'm getting mine. Get yours. That's when we start going on a down climb.
Yeah.
You know, we start integrating and all that. No, we don't need no damn integration. We need segregation.
Jamita Jilly.
We need segregation. Integration probably was good for back then, but right now, these Negroes
what have lost their manners. What have integration done for us?
Made us lose our mind as a people. Made us lose our mind because that's what make those sisters that and it's hard for me to call them sisters because anytime a black woman can get stumped and kicked and disrespected and they basically hold a child hostage and then the other one go in there and get their nails did, it's something wrong with that picture.
Yeah.
You know, so we lost our mind with integration. So let's go back to segregation for a while so they can find themselves. Because we know who we are. We found ourselves.
No question.
You know, they need to find themselves.
Yeah.
You know?
Man, that's a great lesson, man. History best reward all research. Mm-hmm. And most of us really don't have time to research or even gather new information. Except if somebody say something.
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing how easy, and that's probably why social media is so popular, because when you say something, you can say something, and people take it as gospel.
Mm-hmm.
Even without facts, no proof, no nothing.
As long as you got some likes.
As long as you got some likes. And that's what this is all about.
Yeah.
That, now understand, if you don't know who this brother is, if you don't know who I am, we're by action. I don't care what nobody say, how much they talk. I'm about action. I'm about delivering the goods, and that's the way I always been.
Mm-hmm.
We've been today. I'm going to tell you what ECCSC has done, me and other brothers in the association. We have put over, sit your butt. We have put over 150 guys to work. That means from the community. Mom, when you take them young brothers off the street and give them a job, what happened?
Their whole life changed. And see, we must get our people to understand that when we take a young man or a man and put him to work, it is then his duty to go back and take care of his community.
His community.
You got to go back and take care of your community. Take care of your family. Because if you don't, just like one of the guys, we got a job a long time ago. Got him a job, and he got a couple of checks. And his children's mother came back to us and said, well, man, why did y'all get, I almost said his name, you know, why did y'all get him a job? I said, because, you know, as a man, he need to have a job to take care of his family. We said, well, the babies don't have Pampers. The babies don't have a bed.
Right.
And so we brought him back in after work. And, hey, man, the children's mother left. And he went to start flying off the handle. Hey, that's not, why your children don't have no Pampers in a bed? Man, you know what I'm saying? This is my money. You know what we did? You know what we did?
Fine.
We went right back to the site and protested the site and told them, we don't even want no more jobs. We just want our member fired.
That's it.
And guess what we did the job?
Wow. Gave it to
the children's mother.
Oh.
We gave it to the children's mother, so we know she going to take care of the baby.
No doubt.
So don't think that you can come get a job amongst us to be a better Negro than you were before you got the job.
Yeah.
We're trying to make you out of a black man and go back and take care of your family. And if you don't, we're going to get you fired.
And the other thing is the violence that we prevent, bro. It's amazing to me that I know in collaboration with myself, you, others, about five or six other groups that I can name, and some that I can't name off the top of my head, we've stopped violence. We de-escalated violence. We stopped shooting. We stopped murders.
Yes.
And that never resonates because they don't become murders. Mm-hmm. And the police and the police chasing, the news chasing, the body chasers, they don't record when a murder don't happen.
Mm-hmm. There's no way to measure or quantify that.
Prevention is not popular.
Right.
So you have these groups receiving funds, resources, like they violence prevention people, but the face don't look like you and
without
I. Although they use people like us get at them young men.
Give them $10 or $20 an hour off $100 million contract or $20 million contract or whatever they getting. Give a few guys that know some guys in the neighborhood and everything. So it's all a facade to get the millions of dollars next year. And so our thing is that I think Thursday, we're gonna put the message out there. By Thursday, we're gonna hit the ground in that area that Mayor Lightfoot has gridded out on the west side, for example, right? I don't like to say half the town because, you know, hey, we all Chicago. One black people in this city, and even when I make a mistake and say that, I always catch myself because, you know,
what they're experiencing on the west side is the same experiencing on the south side.
And if we don't come together, we all going to be outside.
Outside.
So that area that she's gridded out from Lake Street to the expressway to 290, from Hamlin to Costner, we're going to go in that area, take over every vacant abandoned property. We're going to talk to the guys and girls that are standing out on the blocks. We're going to clean the blocks up and turn things around because we know their solution is always mass incarceration.
Hey, Mark, one thing the person told me to say and ask you as they asked me this question, it was funny to me, but I had to, I mean, it wasn't funny, it was serious. So you not afraid of them Nipsey hustling you? If you understand what I'm saying,
let me say it like this right
here. They asked me this question.
I understand.
Tyrone, with what y'all doing, because they've been cowards for so long, and to see us stand up against construction companies, unions, they said, man, they going to send some black people, man, to Nipsey hustle y'all, man.
Well, let me answer it like this. You better Nipsey hustle me before I Nipsey hustle you, because I ain't never did a gun turn in. I don't support gun turn-ins. They be talking about, what they say, the gun legislation. What they call it? They call it something.
Sensible gun control.
Gun control and all that, you know what I'm saying?
Take your guns and
man,
they shoot
look,
you.
Look, the only gun control you're going to get from me is that when it ain't on, I just got the gun sit to the side. That's the only gun control you're going to get from me. Look, I believe in dying in the hell of a bullet, even if it's a police officer. If he trying to kill me, if I'm in the alley, let me look at this live. Because I want the police to understand this. I'm not one of those young kids that y'all run him in the alley and you blow his brains out and then you put a gun on him. See, I went through that at 15 years old. The police chased me. They chased me on Springfield and Roosevelt. And when I got in the alley, that police officer tried to kill me. I didn't have a gun on me. I didn't have drugs or nothing on me. And not that it justifies them being able to do that, even if I did have it on me.
Right.
But he shot at me. And I told myself for the rest of my life, if I ever was running in the alley with a police officer and he saw a gun on me, and I know he got a gun, I'm going to blow his goddamn brains out before he blow mine out. Plain and simple.
Uh-oh.
That's how it worked with me. You know what I'm saying? I make no mistake. I ain't biting my tongue about it, period. You're not going to kill me. You're not going to kill me because I got children and grandchildren and parents and people that are dependent on me. So I got to go home to my family like you feel like you want to go home to your family.
It's only right men should be able to defend themselves. And because someone is a police, it should give him the right to kill me because he has a badge. So with that being said, continue to watch CAN TV, ECCSE on CAN TV. Share it and let your people know there's a lot of great programs on this here at CAN TV. Get you some information, get you some knowledge. Second of all, Cream, you got something to say? Say something, say bye to the people. Say bye to the people, Cream. So thank you all for tuning in and continue to support them brothers and sisters who's protesting at that nail salon. Thank you. Peace.